Attention all citizens of Bottle Rocket hell? Gaming.
What the?
Attention all citizens of Bottle Rocket Gaming.
What the?
Please be aware that police are searching for Lindsay of Not Quite Nerds for the murder of Bob the Bum.
Making a bottle rocket.
The last big thing I want to dive into on the industrial or kind of industrial area / away from the industrial area is actually diving into rails. And I actually do want to hand this off to Tox because there's a lot here that me and him worked on. But he came onto the server. Me and Yankee were kind of doing rails. He decided to take up the mantle of head of rails, and he ran with it. And boy, howdy, did he freaking run with it, because we now have automated rail systems that go to many different towns that are up to 2,500 blocks away. Our system is completely automated, at least at one place where the Bee Sanctuary not only delivers stuff to us automatically, but also sends out trains automatically when it needs stuff from us, which is pretty damn impressive. So what do you want to start with this, Tox?
I guess we'll start at the Brad station because we're staring right at this. Was actually
start with
our last. Oh, I didn't even see it.
Get out of my face. There's a bug here.
Oh, I didn't even see the large blue building.
Yeah, I totally missed it. Wait, what does BRAT stand for again?
Bottle Rocket Area Transit. I think it was, you said it was RG, right, that came up with that?
Yes.
Yeah, I came up with the name because in the rough area where I live, there's a BART, which is Bay Area Rapid Transit. So I swapped around a couple letters.
Wow.
I love the computer up here.
Yes.
Yeah, the computer is not as cool as it used to be.
Yeah.
The computer used to swear at you.
Yeah, if you didn't make a choice in time, it used to use an explicit word. I have it on video.
Programming but, at its finest.
Yeah. But, this is our ticket to Spencer. You can buy a ticket here.
Our ticket to ride?
Somebody just bought a ticket for the South.
Oh, god damn it, man. Really?
Yes.
Now, if we look down here, kind of look down at the trains.
Yep. Our different lines.
Yep. And then this is where you go down to depart. There's four different lines on the trains. Trains are obviously stopped right now. We mentioned it earlier, we had to do a server rollback after VSD crashed the server again, and I never bothered to fix the trains again, because when the server rolls back, trains tend to scatter, and I really didn't feel like picking everything up at the time.
Yeah, the trains do have a known issue when, if they're live on rails and stopping rails, when the server reboots, it causes problems.
It wasn't just that, though.
I mean, if you want to know the full,
it has even more problems.
Yeah, I mean, if you want to know the details about all that, me and Tox actually talk about it at length in our on our channel, some of our episodes.
Yeah.
But the intention of this was just to be a nice, cool place where you can basically pick a train to the cardinal direction you wanted to go and have a nice choo-choo ride.
Four different routes. Got him. Oh, he was flying around the room.
Oh.
What's next, Tox?
I guess we'll go outside. Actually, let's pretend I just arrived on a train, and I'll go up the arrival stairs. Because I'm picky like that. Oh yeah, by the way, this is a stair down to the subway tunnels. There's a subway station down there.
Yes, yeah, so there's actually a subway station for the industrial that we never, again, didn't get a chance to do the subway, unfortunately. I vow to fix this on the new server.
Yes. Talk about the parkade. You may notice light on here. This is VSD's work. This tells us that there's a train stopped on the line for a certain amount of time, which means there's probably trains.
Oh, this was a goddamn piece of brilliance. We talk about the aspect of trains getting stuck on the tracks for whatever reason.
Like that guy there.
VSD actually invented this system right here, and it seems kind of silly to have lights here because, well, if the light's here, you're here, and obviously if you're here, you can see the fucking train being stopped. But the reality is we actually use Dynamaps to look at our server. And with Dynamaps, you can actually see these lights if they're on or off. So we can just glance at Dynamaps actually being online, and we can tell if there's problems on the rails.
Yeah, because it takes a while to log in.
Shut it.
I wasn't making fun of you.
Details.
No, that was preemptively for Seshi.
Oh, okay.
But she's got a new computer now, so it's all better.
Ah, yeah, yes, that's true.
I got a new graphics card.
In case anybody's wondering, this red light here is because there's a train about to emerge from the stations, and this is a really blind corner, and I run really fast down here.
Trains kill people.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and the one thing that I did invent on this server is the roundabouts.
Yes, actually.
That was your idea.
That was actually Sesh's idea. We actually, me and Tox wrestled with trying to do intersections. And had all kinds of problems with trains repeatedly somehow getting intersections together and making big bada booms.
Yeah.
And so Sesh made a comment of, well, what about a roundabout?
And we talked brilliantly.
Yeah, we can talk to some testing on it, and this is what we end up coming up with. And again, if you want to see the details of how the roundabout works, you can check out me or Tox's channels. We talk about the logic and everything that's put into this to make it work. But it was a brilliant piece of work. It really makes for efficient intersections.
Mm-hmm.
Parkade?
The rest of the of the industrial area here. Just give me a second. Whenever I start recording, my ears start to drive me crazy, so it's kind of annoying.
That's a weird thing to have. You should see a doctor.
Yeah, it is. I've been seeing doctors, actually. That's one of the reasons I haven't been around.
Oh.
Yeah.
Sorry. Anyways.
But anyways, we got the industrial area here. Warped already pointed out the power station where the trains come in and pick up power. There's special trains for that. This train drops off sludge. The green train and the yellow train here go down to the parkade, and this is the entrance here. Again, it's a blind corner, so I put up a light, because when I'm running really fast, I tend to hit the trains as they're coming out. And that is not the official entrance to the parkade.
Sorry.
You guys are all doing it wrong and disobeying the sign that is directly above you. If we go into the data center.
Do not play on the tracks. Got it.
And so this is our parkade. Wasn't much room in the industrial area, so we had this brilliant idea to go underground, and it looks really freaking cool down here.
Come right in here where I'm standing, and shift.
Uh-huh.
Oh, it's one of those.
I forgot about that.
Ooh.
Bye,
D-Dog.
And so the trains come down here, and they're...
God, this was work. Crap.
Oh, yeah. They're filtered right here first between the lime green trains, which come to drop off materials from forestry town and whatnot. And it just kind of a first come, first serve. So the first train that comes goes in this line, second train that comes goes here.
Long story short, it's all set up under here to both be a place for trains to come to drop off items from other cities, as well as for other cities to have items be picked up.
Are you saying I talk too much, Warped?
No, I'm just saying we've got this all...
Why did you interrupt me and say long story short?
Because we have this all explained in our channel, mister.
Yeah, I'm doing a really quick explanation. I'm not doing a full half-hour explanation. And these lines here are for trains to pick up items to bring them to other towns, and these are filtered by item, and the reason for that is all explained.
This design was more or less talks. He wanted to do a parkade, and we came up with this like thick color. Ah!
Sorry. Ah! I tried hitting the mute.
What?
Too slow.
What?
Oh my greatness.
So, but this was a lot. This was a fun build. Again, it was again. You know, it's community. It's me and Tox working on this. We figure out the logic. The little control building there actually has all of the head units that run all this logic. So these are actually not just ornamental. They are actually functional. This is what ran everything. But that's not all. The trains were really kind of a center point for our server and the logistics of our server. Our server kind of adapted and evolved to kind of accommodate the trains, really. And that's one of the kind of key things about I loved about this was that they really became a big point of connection for us since we had cities so far away.
Mm-hmm.
And the last big part of the trains is over here at the train yard. This became Tox's home for all kinds of mad science stuff.
And some of this is Warp's Mad Science Anvil.
Oh, that's an interesting switch. Arc trains actually, for server reboot.
Yeah.
Nice.
And we talked about that in a video recently, too.
By the way, in fact, one of our last videos, I think, we just went over that.
Mine's still going up on Friday, but by the time you guys see this on my channel, it will already be up.
Actually, this this building right here is a fun building because I actually built this building here where the data center is. And then I decided I wanted to separate the trains out further. And so instead of ripping this whole thing down and rebuilding it, I actually used the frames mod and actually picked this entire building up and flew it over to this location and landed it.
Good lord.
Yep.
Yeah.
Again, what you can do with mods is amazing. So
I'd also like to point out this, well, actually it's just, it's on this floppy right now. This is the first computer craft program I ever made.
97.
Right here.
Ah, oh, yes, our train building kit.
Whoops. Because we had a...
quick math.
We had a book full of all the different standards for colors on for our trains, and it was becoming really hard to manage, so I made it into a program instead.
Which, again, was the color coordination was another brilliant piece of work by Cox. It was actually one of the first big things he did when he came on board as the rail yard person, is he standardized how we were going to sift and sort our trains. So when all these trains head out from this centralized place, all of the routing is taken care of by color code or by ticket, and so the trains actually know how to get to where they need to go.
Yeah.
So would anyone like to take a guess how long in years this Minecraft world has been up? Minecraft years, I should say.
How many?
13.9 years. That's 5,097 days.
Nicely.
Yeah.
Good lord.
Yeah, so that's a lot. That rail building was one of the first elements of the official train system yard, rail yard we started to build. And the last thing we built was actually a rail yard. An actual functional, had a purpose rail yard, actually.
Yeah, there were plans to put like a rail yard over here, but obviously this is just empty desert area,
and a little bit small.
Not desert.
Can I flip the button? Can I flip the button? Can I?
Yeah.
Oh no!
I don't want to push the button. You can all gather around the sign there.
Yeah, right here.
So well, the last thing we talked about.
Children.
One of the big things we had an issue with was if the server does an auto restart now and then, help keep it clear and running. The issue with that was if trains were across those holding tracks when the server restarted, they would forget that they were transversing that and it would lock them in place and basically back up the line and everything would kind of go all herpy derpy. It was kind of a problem.
We talked about this on our channels, Warped.
Yes, we did. But I'm proud of this one because it was a brilliant piece of work. Nevertheless,
I was playing Space Engineers when Warp found this.
Yeah, it was great. It was absolutely great. It's on, just for the record. Your computers don't work. Oh, there it goes.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it checks every like 30 seconds or something. If there's a signal.
Gotcha. So Tox put this in and made me absolutely giggle. The switch does two things.
I tried many times to catch him giggling. I finally got one recently.
But basically, the switch basically routes all
the
trains.
The server will be shutting down soon. All trains, please report to the rail yard.
Yeah, and that also sends the trains to this rail yard here.
I can't hear the audio on this thing. For some reason, it doesn't work on my system.
Your audio
is
probably
actually
turned down.
I don't hear anything either.
If you have blocks turned down, all that. But nonetheless, the trains will come in here. They park all the trains,
and
you can reboot the server.
Warped.
Yeah, you have one master volume.
Yeah.
In any case,
you talked about the blocks.
Oh yeah. Well, anyways, but this was another brilliant piece of work I love about the server because this was straight up us figuring out how to fix an issue, like what I would call a glitch, if you will, the system being the trains would get screwed up if server rebooted. and we fixed that problem with mods. There was no configurations or updates and like that or patches. This was just us straight up finding a way around it. Park the trains, then reboot the server, then release the trains again. So that was pretty much the kind of pinnacle of us and our logic in that. Talks, was anything else about trains you wanted to reminisce about?
No.
All right. So beyond that, that's everything in our wonderful, illustrious little town here. Again, the theme of
we did not go back around to the motel.
Oh, we will. Yes, absolutely. We will get right back to the motel for certain. Yeah, you're absolutely right. But part of our theme became having the central city and then having these remote towns. And this really worked well for our community because, like with most servers, people tend to have that spawn village everybody starts at, and they build a little hut there. But then they run off some inexplicable distance and made their own little private compound. Nobody really got together. And it's kind of typical of most servers. For us, it was very different because we always tend to always hang out together. We always did a lot of stuff together.
Which I like.
Yeah, and it's a very different dynamic, and it's great because when people did run off to do things, they ran off to do themed things. VST started doing a magic town, Seshi had a mining town, BDA did a games town. He built a brilliantly beautiful,
amazing.
Yeah, arena, like, you know, Hunger Games style arena, like glass top, you could watch the action kind of a thing. He did all the pretty, and again, typical to community personality, I came in, did all the tech to get it working so people would be launched up into play and had, you know, chests filled up with items randomly and things like that. So it just really, really humbling, kind of neat how, again, it's just all of us work together on stuff to make things happen. And it's just this is exactly what we wanted for this community. And this is what's happened. And we've carried that forward into the new server for certain. Actually, new servers, actually. So that's pretty neat.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know. I mean, VSC, did you have any desire to show off Magic Town? Or I know it's not really much built there, but...
There never really did get to be much. There was that oasis with, like, the spa water, which was pretty cool. But I
wouldn't mind going over there.
Okay.
It was one of those I was waiting for inspiration to hit, and inspiration every time it hit would like knock me out.
fair enough. But nonetheless, so yeah, so let's go ahead and we're gonna skip back over to our main town again here. Oh. Yay. Actually gonna take the road back out of industrial towards midtown here with the defunct bridge. One of the my bills on high on design from doing so well. The other things I decided to take on doing a diagonal bridge, and diagonals in Minecraft suck. Trying to build a bridge in diagonal was, you know, a lot of suck.
And then if we go over here, we get just a lot of absolute hell for a while there.
Oh god, there was.
Oh, the tanks.
Freaking cursed earth over there.
Oh yeah, that was bad. Oh. Actually, yeah, before we're running back into midtown here, I forgot. We have bees. RG, do you want to say anything about bees or just yep, they're there.
I'm lost.
Okay, yeah, I'm in the process of heading over. When this was probably right around when we got notably started with the railcraft. One of the things that I noticed and Seshi noticed was that we were really, really low on bag space. Mm-hmm. And we knew about the 45 slot bags that you needed to use bees to make. So I, through a little bit of help from Yankee's previously done bee sanctuary at his place, I started making up more bees, and finally I decided, you know what, this is going to require its own area. So I went a bit out of the way, set up some custom set up a few alveolaries, and used the logistics pipes to automate them. And then VST came in and made it look a little bit prettier using micro blocks, and then the micro blocks broke, so you'll see one of these is kind of busted up.
Ever since that happened, I was afraid the same would happen to City Hall.
Yeah, I know. It could be pretty bad. So this was just all about bees, and it looks a little kind of peaceful and serene on top. If you go down under, it goes... Actually, I would honestly say if you go down under here, you will find something that is organized, but as close as you'll ever come to what the workshop was underground.
And another example.
Yeah, I kind of had the tendency, I wanted everything, as much stuff in one room as possible.
Compact. Pff, whatever.
Yeah. But then there's also, if you go down here, there's a ladder which goes all the way down to bedrock. And I was basically making multiple floors of...
hell?
Sorry, multiple floors of where it's just bee alveolaries. And again, using the logistics pipes to pump them up upstairs. Anything that we needed to constantly be making, I just set up a set of alveolaries with that particular type of bee, and it just fed back into itself so that the princess and queen would keep coming back and making more bees and making more stuff.
Gotcha. Very cool. And you also can see a little more of Viesti's chitty window technology, mm-hmm. and also see a little more of the rails. And the rails were fun too, because this was one of the few, well, only towns that had that automatic call system. Me and Tox set up so that this city, without any human interaction, could actually send out trains to actually go pick up items it needed to produce what it produced. So that was a real thing. And again, if you want to see details on that, we talk about it in one of our last couple of videos on rails. But really nice. And I know I say this over and over again, but this is all about community, and this is what we're talking about. RG gets in the bees, VST pre's it up, me and Tox come in and do logistics for it. This is what Bottle Rocket is. And, you know, this is the kind of community we've tried to build. This is why we're very selective about the people we bring into our servers, because, you know, we don't want to spoil this. It's all about the whole quality over quantity thing. So we've always appreciated having good people. We haven't missed yet. You know, I mean, yeah, Rourke has his days, but we still love him.
Hey,
you gotta understand this, Rourke.
I kid. Me and Rourke are having a good time on the new server building the airport, but I'm going to go ahead and zip over here to the...
Actually, do you want to take a look at Magic Town after all? I realized, even though I never got completed, there are some pretties there.
There are some pretties there. Now, certainly, certainly can go over there in a bit and take a look at it. It's a bit far out, and I hate to drag things on too much longer, but I also want to go over to Gamestown, get some last footage, if you will, of the arena and some of the stuff there, because it's an impressive feat. It really
it is.
BD will be working on the new Gamestown.
Yep.
Okay, so we're at Skeezy.
I'll be working on the...
We're heading back over to the Skeezy Motel, back to Midtown here. Skeezy Motel is actually just behind the workshop where we first came in. You can see the relation. The Skeezy Motel was something that I originally had built or aspired to build back in our 1.4 mod pack and server. This is the untalked about, kind of aborted mod pack. It was me and Turgo's first attempt at building a mod pack and hosting a server, and it didn't really get its legs before we realized that 1.4 was effectively dead. Mods were not supporting it anymore. People had moved on. It was a very short turnaround cycle for mod support compared to other... Well, we're talking about a time when I think we hung on 1.25 forever in a day. Then all of a sudden it was on to 1.4 and then on to 1.5. So we kind of scrapped and redealed the mod pack for 1.5. And Heather kind of championed bringing the Skeezy Motel over. So we brought the Skeezy Motel over. And this was, play on words, kind of a fun play on words of the Skeezy Motel, you know, snow and all that. But this basically was a place where people who are new to the server, until they have a chance to get their legs about them, start mining the stuff, start building their home over the residential. This was just a place where they could actually stay. And people would check in at the office here. We had a book. Hey, Linz.
Hi. Welcome to Azeskizi.
And then this was cool. This is one of the things that kind of developed from this that I love is you can actually see when people joined our servers. You've got Rurark, then you've got ADDF Toxic here, and so on. So you get to see when people came in. Some people put little notes in. Just some fun stuff. So this is a book that we're going to keep for prosperity, so to speak. I'll try to find a way to copy it over to the new server. And then people could pick a room out. And Heather did this wonderful work of every room is a custom look here. So the bathrooms are all identical. The bathrooms are horrendous. First of all, because they're friggin' pink. Second of all, because Heather decided she wanted a window door for the bathrooms.
Oh, yeah.
I swear to God, Heather and friggin' Tigrix, man. You guys are a bunch of weirdos. My favorite room is the room 3 here, because you'll damn near go blind from the colors, which after making many comments about the color coordination, my wife then points out to me, oh yeah, that's the colors of my college.
I never chose room 3.
One of the rooms down here.
That was my room too.
I love this one right here.
Room 5 was my room.
Room 5 is actually an homage to the original Skeezy. The color coordination inside this room here was the actual original Skeezy room color. Right down to the popcorn ceiling. So, that's a Skeezy.
And some of us never moved out of the Skeezy.
Yes, especially likes living the motel life. Cheap services, really close to the laundromat, you know. Important things in life.
I love the TP rules.
And please observe, no diving in the pool.
Yeah, I forgot about this laundry room.
Well, the pool's always frozen solid, so I don't think so. Diving in, it's a good idea.
There's a corner. There's a small corner.
Actually,
over. There's a small corner, yes. Well,
we should invite that German guy who likes jumping into frozen swimming pools.
Yeah, it looks really fun.
Now we should move around back to the Skeezy.
Yeah, so around the back, Skeezy had a nice little build here for a dumpster that I built I love so much.
I'm stuck in the pool.
Damn it, Tosh. And then we had a person who moved in. His name was Bob.
Oh, God, Bob.
Bob was a great guy. He never bothered anybody. By the way, this is not Bob. This is George. George is holding a vigil for Bob. Bob just hung out here. Bob was never a problem. Never hurt anybody. He was a good friend of ours. So, unfortunately, he passed away through violent causes. And we wanted to go ahead and wrap up this server tour. We're gonna head over to the cemetery here. And sure. I wanted to take a little bit of time to say a few words about Bob here, because Bob was a great guy. He was inspiration. He was a mascot. He really embodied how us as a community came together and helped each other out and inspired each other. And just, he was an inspiration. And I just want to say that I will deeply miss Bob, and I just although his passing was violent, I like to feel that he's in a better place, and I will. I will hope that we can find resolution, because he was a truly great guy, and I will miss him.
I remember one of the best conversations I had with him. It was during a tough time in my life, and he gave me the greatest advice. It was
Bob.
Oh my God.
Bob never had to say much to be understood.
As long as he's always drunk. In his hand.
A man of few words.
A man of few words. Breaks my heart. Truly does.
Craft on here.
I'm crying.
Well, Bob.
To Bob, of course.
To Bob. To Bob.
And to the MAB server. This was a lot of fun.
Yes, it has, and I do want to say that it's been an absolute blast. I mean, to have this much fun and have this many people, here to do what we've done and to build what we've built, this never would have happened even remotely without everybody who's been a part of it, both here today with us as well as people who have weren't able to make it. It has been a wonderful, wonderful event, and it's always humbling just because you don't get a chance to see this kind of personality a lot sometimes. There's a lot of good servers out there, don't get me wrong, but this of course is special because this is what I'm on kind of a thing. But just seeing how people end up reacting, how people get along and do stuff, it's humbling, and look around all the stuff we built here. This didn't exist and we made it happen, and I think in the end I think it really says something. And I hope that this carries on into the new servers. I hope that we can find more good people and
attention all citizens of Bottle Rocket
hell?
Gaming.
What the?
Attention all citizens of Bottle Rocket Gaming.
What the?
Please be aware that police are searching for Lindsay of Not Quite Nerds for the murder of Bob the Bum.
Zero was too damn high.
Zero committed suicide.
If you have any information of the whereabouts of Lindsay of Not Quite Nerds, please notify the police immediately. Do not approach the suspect.
I saw Lindsay drowning herself
Repeat,
earlier over this
do not
over
approach
here.
The suspect.
I think the problem solved.
I think the problem solved. This is Minecraft, though, that people tend to regenerate.
Mm.
We should keep our eyes open for her.
No.
My debt is paid.
That was an unexpected.
this is kind of a Romeo and Juliet thing. This is just, I don't know.
Oh, God. Tox, thank you for that. Honestly.
Wow. Or you just, oh, God.
Ladies and gentlemen, again, thank you so very much, guys. It has been a lot of hard work to bring Ball Rocket to the level that it's at, to do the things that we've done, and to just get the people together that we have gotten together. I have sunk a lot of time in my life, and Turgo's life and everybody's life into this. So to everybody who's pitched in, been a part of it in some way or another, I just want to say a big giant thank you. And I also want to say a big thank you to Viesti taking on the mantle of chapter leader going into the new season and forward. And, good luck to you on that, sweetie. And thank you so much for taking that on, because it is a challenging thing to do. And I really appreciate you stepping up on it.
Don't screw it up.
What's wrong with me? I thought that this would be a,
So
we're all screwed.
We're all screwed. That's all. We're all done. It's done. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. One last time, MA server, incredible. Looking forward to playing with you guys a lot more on the Cherry Bomb and on the Sparkler servers that we have up now. Of course, I expect to see grand things and lots of fun and us pulling all kind of shenanigans and pranks, much like Toxus here.
God damn.
And, unfortunately, it decided just didn't want to work at first.
You know, it happens. It's great community here, and I'm looking forward to that. I'm also looking forward to see, you know, what new comes our way in terms of people and things. So, you know, God knows who we're going to have next, what's going to happen. So I'm looking forward to it. So again, guys, thanks a lot. And
there's Lindsay.
It's a ghost.
Get her.
Get her.
And we'll just end this on murder. So have a great time, guys.
Glasses on my 3D glasses.
Yeah, I put them on my green glasses.
And on that bombshell, as Tox would say, have a good life.
Have a good life.
Bye!
Bye!
Bye.
In the words of Bob,
We'll be right back.